Hello, everybody. Welcome back to OCD Hi-Fi Guy. And tonight we're going to show you rig setup 101. Things do sound fabulous in here, but as soon as I bring in my better ears, which are female ears, always better than mine, in noticing small nuances of the music, she pointed out that she felt the mid-range was a little high. Now, she's absolutely correct, because the drivers that I put on the outside of the magna pans here are 4 ohm, and the factory ones were 8 ohm. So that means when I am utilizing the same setup, the same parameters, well, let's put it this way. The other drivers on the magna pans are also 8. So when you've got a 4 in here, it'll be more pronounced, right? Because it's more, it just gets more power. It's because it's 4 ohm. So you'll hear whatever, if you switch a driver out of your speaker that was an 8 ohm and you put in a 4 ohm, that driver is going to be more pronounced for sure than it was before. And so I do have settings on the passive crossover, which is where I would correct for that. But in order not to do this by ear and to take measurements, what everybody should have that is serious about, let's say if you're a staunch audiophile, you're going to have music, or you're going to have a room software, room correction software. It's not, it's more just measuring software. It doesn't have the algorithms to, I'll change it and correct it on my own, but this will tell me where the room acoustics are at, okay? There's many different parameters in here. You can see up here, there's a frequency response, SPL, spectrum, there's an O-scope, the distortion that it's hearing, the reverb, and the bass decay. So all of these things must be compensated for if you really are serious about listening. Otherwise, you're listening to all sorts of crap. You're listening to echoes, you're listening to music that's coming, arriving at your ear at like 4 different times. So there's, you know, all sorts of crap going on. You can see right now, the microphone's picking up my voice. The mic is over there, okay? And you get this software on Parts from Parts Express. It's like $350. It's called, what is it? OmniMic. OmniMic, is it? OmniMic, M-I-C. And you get a microphone over there, USB mic. You buy the stand. You get a, you take a USB cable. You put the software on your laptop. And then you've got, you pull it up here, and then between this, and then here's how I control my rig, and I have the, these are all the samples that the software uses. It's from Dayton Audio, so you'll see, if you go up top, that's the, you know, the CD is Dayton Audio OmniMic System B2 Audio Test Tracks. So you go into here, and you just play back these tracks, and then the microphone listens, and it knows what it's listening for, and you get a good reading. So what we'll do here is we'll start with a no, we want to be on the right channel, and we want to do the short sine sweep. Here we go. So let's see. I don't want this to be too loud. You gotta always check that, because you can turn that thing on, and then all of a sudden, whoa, you're like, oh my god, it's too loud. Okay, so let's turn this down. But you do want it, you know, at some decent level. So let's see. Okay, let's go.
Track 12. Right
channel short sine sweep. Okay. See, we are at 30-35. Those are 5 dB steps. Okay, so what we're seeing here, as you see, dip here. This is to be expected, because this is the low frequency. It's not really reading that very well anyways. Anything from like here down, you can ignore. This is all over the place. Now, we are kind of far from the speaker. We could be hearing the room in this. So what we can do if we want to is we grab some panels like that, and we put them. I'll show you if we want to really kind of just to ensure things. Now, I think I took the other ones out. I'll have to go grab at least, so I have 2 of these in here, but okay. So we'll go like, well, You can put these up on the two sides. I gotta move this preamp. I got this NAT preamp down here. Let's see. Here, look inside there for a while. Move this puppy. Okay. Okay, so take this and go like that. So we would do something like this just to keep wall reflection off. Normally I'd put two, I'd put one there, I'd put one right here too. But I think the other one is outside at the shop. At least that'd keep, you know, any potential wall reflections. But even though these things aren't, they don't really, they beam, so they don't really, panels don't usually reflect up, like off the ceiling, or off to the sides very much like box speakers do. So anyways, let's see if we get a different reading.
Track 12, right channel, short sine sweep.
Okay, so we definitely see a pronounced mid-range. Our bass is up over here, so I would tend to want to bring this, actually, so you can either bring this up or you can bring this down. I usually like to cut more than I like to boost. I'm happier cutting things than boosting things, so I'm gonna look at that. Okay. Although this does seem pretty consistent, we may want to just boost this a little bit. Let me try that and see what happens. Okay, so what I will do now is I go over to my crossover here. I've got to watch my nuts on this thing, man. Like, I mean, they're right there, and there's that thing. Zzz, that's like thousands of watts. I mean, thousands of volts. It would not be good. I'd have a smell like some bacon. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so we already have a boost. We're two clicks. You can see right here. We're two clicks above on the high, on both sides. So let's go on the high mid. Let's go one, two, and let's go high mid here. One, two. I actually think it's three. Okay, so one, two, three, and let's see where this comes out now. Okay, so we go back here. Let's run it again.
Track 12, right channel, short sine sweep.
Okay. We've still got an anomaly right here, which makes me think, when you see something like this that's blatant, usually it means a phase issue. And what that means is usually reversing the polarity on the back of a tweeter or a mid. So I think it's going to be, this would be the tweeter. So let's check that out. Okay, so what I will do is, I will go back here to where the tweeter is, right, y'all? And I will reverse the polarity. Look at that. Now we're getting much smoother through there. See, all these little things at this point, they're room anomalies and different crap like that, reflections and stuff. We don't need to worry about the little warbles so much. We just generally want a smooth line, and then we can start tweaking on the other stuff. But for now, I want that down just a little bit right there. Where is that? That's at 500. That's low mid. Let's go over here. All right, we can do this real time. Over to low mid. Low mid. Still a little high. I think we're going to hit it again. I'm gonna hit it two clicks this time. Two, one, two. Yeah, so that at this point, that's fine with me. We don't need to worry about this again. This is fine with me. What I want to do now is pause this, is check the left side. So we'll do this quick. And I did, at the same time, at the same time I did the, oh crap, look what I got, right where I need to set my microphone stand, I got a cable snake pile. Let's see, okay, so I'll go like this. Get this stuff out of the way. Okay, so, put this in here. That's about the same distance. Okay. And again, we're doing rough general stuff right now, just to do a rough quickie, okay? Because we can really put the pedal to the metal later if we want to. I'm not going to worry about reflections. I just want to see right now if that notch is going to be there, because I have not reversed this tweeter yet. So let's see. We want to go to left channel now, short sine sweep.
Track six, left channel, short sine sweep.
She looks pretty damn good. So now this will be something that'll just, you know, bother me for a while, but I'm going to ignore it. Is like, how come there's not a notch over there on the left one? It's in phase, presumably, meaning we're not picking up on it with our reading. We're not seeing anything that looks like a phase anomaly. And if those cables are not reversed, if they're on right, okay, then, you know, then I start going, well, which component has a phase anomaly in it? Like, how come it's, you know, is it inside a component somewhere? So now these are in phase. Though, you know, see, or here's another thing. Because I did this mod here, I asked myself, okay, so I put the red on the right closest to the tweeter on when I did both sides, but what if they don't do that? What if they keep them, if they're the same on both sides? Like, red is on the right, regardless if it's here, regardless if it's there. So if red is on the right over there, it's the one away from the tweeter, farthest from the tweeter. If red's on the right here, it's the one closest to the tweeter. So do I leave red on the right? Usually, I would have followed my positive down from the panel to there, so I doubt I would have made that mistake, but it can happen. Mistakes can happen. So that would be my next thing, is that done properly? We go over here. Yep, it's on the amp correctly. You know, so there's, oh man, I mean, there's like, you know, eight different places that it could be, you know, that is not the wire. It could be inside any of the components. It could be inside the wiring of the speaker. It could be inside, oh man, a lot of things. Okay, so it seems as though we are in better shape now. Now I will go back to the song that we were listening to and see if it sounds mid-high like it did before.
Say you are my friend. down. You just bring it.
Definitely better than it was before. Okay, so it is better than it was before. Okay, so we can feel happy. We can feel, you know, solid. We can feel like, okay, we did find a glitch. We found something that was wrong. The mid definitely was up high. And so we corrected for that. We found a phase anomaly in that tweeter or on this side that we fixed. And now the two channels are much better balanced, and they're more flat and more linear than they were before with that push on the mid. So now we know we're in much better shape than we were a bit ago. And the things that we changed, you might have heard if you're a real pro, you can hear things like that tweeter out of phase, you know, and everything. I am not quite that good. I can hear it if it's really blatant, but unless it's super blatant, I'm not going to be able to discern those. And so I use software, and really anybody that's serious about this should get a laptop, you get your software, and that way you can measure this. You get a microphone and you just put it out there, man, and you measure it. And then that way you know for sure what the things measure like. And you're going to get much more accurate with something like that than just guessing. And it's much quicker. So there you go. There's some rig tweaking 101. Get yourself some software. Dayton Audio OmniMic, $350. That's all it is, man. And that will help you get things totally correct. Because guessing is one thing. Measurement is a whole nother. All right, see you.